month back. I call up one of my friends and he says, "Hey, I'm in a meeting. Can I call you back?" I said, "Sure." And I call him back after like 1 hour and he says, "I said I'm in a meeting right now. Don't you understand that? Let me call you back." To which I politely said, "If you are in a meeting, and if your meeting was that important, and if you're really having this one-on-one conversation with your boss, then why are you even commenting on your ex-girlfriend's status updates?" And that big macho man, I could actually hear him mutter something, go on and on over phone, and I could actually imagine him nodding like an ox, but all he could say out was a hmm. One thing was sure, that this Facebook was going to ruin my love life, but I was not much worried about that. What I was worried about was about all those boys wanting to be men who in the name of the comment like, "It's not about you, it's about me, my life, my career," kind of a comment, start winding up their love affairs and look out for another girl whom they could listen. Hello? Alright, ladies and gentlemen, fellow Toastmasters, look around. See the pace at which this world is advancing. You could actually see so many hot and happening things. For me at least, the past 2011, I joined Infi Hyderabad. I came here, I was astonished at the number of employees present. And I could actually see the innumerable extramarital affairs going on in my office around me. Yeah, that's the advantage of working there. And you could actually see this innumerable debates going on over TV with Arnab Goswami, the famous, hopping like a kangaroo, trying to interrupt someone in a Times Now debate. And the Hazare fever, wherein you could even hear the slogans like, "Hazaron se dar nahi lagta sahab, Hazare se lagta hai." All this came to remarkableness, if you see, and on the scale of number of goosebumps that you get, if you see, all these things come nowhere close to the rip-tickling anxiety that you get when you're told that the hot babe of your college has actually uploaded a new album to her profile with all the coochie poo pics with her latest profile. You go home, you check out her pics, you start digesting the indigestible facts about her, you start empathizing, sympathizing with all the comments. And then, of course, you curse yourself for having filled such precious time of yours. Call it FBism, FB logy, FB mania, whatever. People these days, every one of us has got an FB ID, no matter he or she has a PAN ID, a passport ID, or yes or no?
Yes.
All right. Facebook, I agree, it has helped us discover our long-lost study buddies from school and college, to relive those memories with them again, to regain the chemistry, to chew the memories, to the time together again. And it's actually a well-established platform to shout and let people know that, look, mine is better than yours. Not to mention, now that quite a few oldies have joined Facebook in the pursuit of remaining in touch with their NRA friends, NRA grandchildren, this has become a walled garden with military level security, wherein you could hide your particular Goa pics from particular people. Talk about pics. These days, most of us make sure, the oldest of the oldest, the busiest of the busiest, make sure that they upload their most flattering Photoshop smoothing pics that make them look actually 10 years younger than what they actually are. And quite conveniently, no social network forces you to display your year of birth, does it? With the advent of Facebook, by the way I'm jabbering till now about going on jabbering about Facebook, you would have made out that I'm a big fan of Facebook. But, and I love wiping away my time and I see my hardcore fans sit and go on like my status update. And so much that these days, the liking thing has taken a whole new meaning. I tell you, I came across one of these girls who uploads this video, 1 million times watched video card, Charlie bit my finger. And she gets these 205 likes and 145 comments with all never ending, "Aww, nice." And there's not even 1% sincerity in all those. Just that, I commented on yours, now you go back to mine. And these days, you want to curse someone, you want to thank someone, you want to like something, or who knows in the future, you want to propose to someone. This is the way. And with the latest timeline thing that has come up, I actually like it. You know why?
Thank you.
Actually made stalking very easier. It actually made stalking very easier. And last but not the least, we have this huge number race to actually get on and add as many friends as we can to add them, any alien possible, and reject the friend request from our own relative in the name of privacy. Who has trouble in saying hello to the person next door? But on Facebook, we are the thickest of friends. You will be seeing us liking each other's comments, commenting on them, having war of words. Or, if you're lucky, you can even see us chatting. I can almost foresee some kind of organization coming up, like the Facebook insiders. Help us find the real him. Or the Facebook insiders. Save girls from jerks. One jerk at a time. And I can actually, it won't be long before the girl's parents, before marrying her, approach these kind of organizations and to go about the guy. The conversation would be something like this. Hello. We would like to get our daughter married to a guy from Delhi. Sure, ma'am. How could we help you? There's this guy called Prashant Saxena from Delhi. We would like to know if he's fit enough for our innocent daughter. Alright, do you have his Facebook ID? Yes. It's prashant.saxena@gmail.com and our daughter has already started chatting with him. Consider that your job is done. We'll get back to you with a detailed analysis and report within 15 days. Now the parents exit the scene and this Facebook analysis press goes on deep into the profile of Prashant Saxena. The trainee creates a girl ID for himself, adds him, whatnot. And in the end, they come up with a report. This guy is not recommended for your daughter. You can as well suggest it to another girl if they want to look. If they are looking for, you will get a 15% discount. And when you show this is the confirmation report which would show the next investigation. God save these jerks and all of these FB maniacs starting from me. And for all those who believed in whatever an iota of what I jabbered till now, I have a small poem for you. It all started with an invite. In a broad daylight.
Wow.
It was sent to friends infinite, yet it meant to excite. And soon I got poked and my emotions got evoked. He proposed, but she got provoked. For no fault of his, he got smoked. I could see linkages, ages and rampages, and onstage and offstage rampages. Facebook, as an idea I had bought, the rest of my life I forgot. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.